Well, the coronavirus may have shut down Pasifika Day in Auckland, but it hasn't impacted on the Polyfest Schools Festival in Christchurch.
That's right. Now, joining us live from the Garden City is reporter Anauli Karima Fai’ai. A very good morning to you, Karima. How are things down there?
Very good morning, JP. Well, it's a little chilly here in Christchurch at the moment. We are struggling a little bit just standing here with our shirts and T-shirts, but we'll get through it.
Now, tell us about the event, because given that Auckland cancelled the Pasifika Festival today, were there any plans to cancel the Polyfest?
Well, there was a bit of fear around that, particularly after the Pasifika Festival was cancelled. But social media, organisers reassured everyone on social media that the event was going ahead. So now it's all go, and as you can see behind me, the festival has just kicked off, and around 30 high schools from across the South Island will be performing today. Nice. So it should be pretty epic.
So tell us, who have you got there this morning?
So to my left here, I have Kenora Pula from Hayata Community College. Very good morning to you.
Good morning.
Now, you performing later on this morning. Tell us, what's the feeling in the camp in the moment? You must be pretty amped.
Yep, really excited, not just to perform, but also excited for all the other schools. So yeah, excited.
Now, tell us a little bit about your performance. I believe it's a mixture of different cultures. Can you tell us what audiences can expect?
Yep, so our performance, we have three cultures involved in it. We have Tokelauan, Tongan and Samoan.
Interesting. And this event is particularly important because it celebrates the diversity here in Christchurch. And to my right here, I have Sia Evalu, who is one of the organisers here at Polyfest. Very good morning to you.
Good morning to you. Thank you.
Sia, tell us, how important is Polyfest to celebrate the diversity here in Christchurch?
Man, as you can see, Polyfest is huge for us, especially in the wake of March 15 last year, just heightens that awareness. And as you can see from the crowds, it's all different cultures represented here today.
Okay, so you mentioned tomorrow is the one-year commemoration of the Christchurch terror attacks. In terms of race relations, what have you observed over the past year? Do you feel there's a greater awareness of the diversity here in Christchurch, or have people stopped talking about it?
Definitely a heightened awareness, especially directly after the event. You still see it now and then, but as I always said, it needs to be more than surface, and we need to show it through our actions, and things like today show that.
Mm. And tell us a little bit about the festival itself. It's the 20th year of Polyfest. What do you make out of the turnout this morning?
Oh, it's awesome. And this is just the start, our very first school. We're expecting a crowd of up to 8,000 to 10,000 to rock up. So if you're out there, please come on down and join us. Yeah. It is 20th year, so 20 years. We've only had to cancel that 1 year due to the 2011 earthquakes. But yeah, so number 19 for us.
Well, on that note, all the best for today, and hope you everything goes well. Now, Polyfest is running till 5 p.m. This afternoon, so if you're in the area, make sure you head on down and check it out. You don't want to miss it. Back to you guys.
Whaftai tele lava, thank you so much, Anauli. Enjoy the rest of the day, and wow, we can hear the singing. I can't smell the food from here, but I hope there's some delicious Pacific cuisine over there. And if you're near the red zone at New Brighton Road, head on over.